I am here with Cyril.
Hi.
And you are from what company, Cyril?
I'm working for Oriflame, a Swedish company.
Oriflame, okay.
And we're present in more than 60 different markets, and so we try to understand most of the markets, I would say.
Okay. You have done a lot of studies on understanding how we perceive age and health.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay.
So what I was presenting yesterday is that we do clinical studies on people. So we take a wide array of measurements over the face, to know the hydration, the sebum, all the type of wrinkles, the size of the pores, and so on. We will also try to connect this to the way people are perceived. So we take full face images of this person,
facial
and we show them to people in the same country. But they have to somehow guess the age of that person. And what's interesting, I think the interesting bit is when someone is perceived older or younger than the real age, we try to understand thanks to a measurement we've done.
Okay, so we have our first guest joining us today. Hi, feeling tired? It's good to see you. I'm starting to get used to seeing your handle. So I'm here with Cyril. He works for Oriflame. And what he does is he studies age perception, how we perceive age and also health based off of our skin. Hi.
Hi.
And so did you want to walk through what you said one more time since we have someone joining us? I want to make sure that they're able to catch up on everything.
Yeah, so basically I was just explaining that the work we do is to understand what are the skin features that influence age perception or health perception. So we take measurements all over the face, hydration, wrinkles, pores, everything you can possibly imagine. But we also take images that we show to people that have to guess how old is that person, and then when someone is perceived younger or older, you try to connect the dots based on the clinical measurements.
This sort of reminds me of that game they play in carnivals, mm-hmm. right, or at the state fair, where they have the person that guesses the age and the weight of the fairgoers. Does anybody know that game at the carnivals? That's sort of like you, but you're coming at it with a lot of science, right?
Yes.
And you're guessing particularly based off of skin. So that makes it harder because you're not using any clothing cues, for example, or you know anything about any other cues aside from the skin we wear.
Yeah. Although there's no cues, our brains are very good since we're all kids. You know, we've been looking at many faces from different ages, from different backgrounds. So we are being aware of that. We're actually paying attention to many skin features across the face, and then we make a judgment based on that. So any person you meet for the first time after a couple of sec, you'll make, without even knowing it, an assessment about how old you think they are, how healthy they are, or even how attractive they are. So you do that job with your brain.
This sounds like a job that can mess up your social relationships.
In a way, yes.
Because you see one layer more than maybe you want to. Okay, so Cyril,
mm-hmm.
I want you to look at my skin and tell me what you see age-wise and health-wise. I'm curious.
Okay, so since now you're smiling, actually, I can see the expression.
Oh my god!
If you don't want to be perceived older, never smile. Keep a poker face.
Poker face. Kidding. Oh, I think they call that like resting bitch face.
Exactly, resting bitch face. That's the key to age gracefully. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. Oh, so I blew it when I smiled. Okay.
Yeah, but like that's normal. Like the wrinkles and the fine lines, they all happening because.
So I'm gonna bring the camera in. Since we're doing this, I might as well go like all the way, right? So. See that? That's what he's talking about. That right there. Got some age. And wisdom. Okay, what else do you see? Uh-oh, let's do what Phil Tyre has to say really fast. What features, cues make someone be perceived older or younger?
Younger.
You're going to go through some of that right now, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
So basically, well, indeed, there's not just the wrinkles. The other cue as well would be like the localized pigmentation. For instance, if you have like the brown spots,
Did you see any of that on me? Was that a cue?
You have a little bit of pigmentation, but I would say that your skin is quite smooth. Like the color is very homogeneous in a way.
Okay.
And we use color heterogeneity as well on top of the wrinkles to make an assessment in terms of age perception. But I would say that the color cues are more related to the healthiness. So if you see people, you know, with a lot of localized redness or a lot of mottled pigmentation here and there, you will make more a health assessment than an age assessment alone.
Okay, so are you making a health or an age assessment right now? Which one are we making?
I'm doing
with
both.
Okay. what else? Hit me with it.
Yeah, no, but I would say what I would pay attention, and most people are paying attention to, is actually the eye area, because the skin is a lot more delicate. That's where we see the first crease and so on. So,
okay, what do my eyes say about,
yeah? Yeah, and in the studies we've done in Caucasian panel, for instance, in Russia,
okay.
The wrinkles around the eye area, so the crossfit here, both of the under eye wrinkles, were one of the most powerful cues at guessing someone's age. But when we've done that in different markets, the skin feature could be different. In India, for instance, they were mostly paying attention to how white, or like pure whiteness, all the skin. Wrinkles came into play, of course, but specifically to that country, how white you were making you feel younger and also healthy. And when you think that in India, you know, you have a caste system, you know, like rich, poor, color, like it's intertwined, and I think it came into play for the judgment. It's a cultural thing.
So this is where cultural norms influence our perception of health and
it does, well. Yeah, and that's why as well, because you have some differences over the world. We have different skin, you know, like people with a strong pigmentation,
yeah,
they will age slower, like African people, for instance, they have a strong melanin content, they're very much protected against the sun.
So are they harder to guess then? Or like make
they're not necessarily harder to guess, but that means the assessment will be done by other things.
I see.
Know, Caucasians, I would get wrinkles easily.
Mm-hmm.
It would be used as a cue. But for African, it would be other things because they're well protected against the sun damage. You know?
Okay. All right. Is there anything else that we can tell you or you perceive from my skin before we move on? You can be a little harsh. I won't mind. I won't cry. I'll wait till afterwards. Go ahead.
What I would say is like something that was very important in China specifically.
Okay.
Like, you know, the oval of your face is actually quite defined, what they call like V-shape, you know, it's very big in Asia.
Do I have a V-shaped face?
I have to say you have a well-defined jawline.
Whoa, okay, so
This was extremely important, yes, for the Chinese, like they were really paying attention to how round was this bit of the face. In Caucasian, it was not that much the case.
I was going to say that's funny because I was in Singapore 2 weeks ago and I saw V-shaped cosmetic type of treatment, so you could get a V-shaped face and I didn't know what it was, and you just answered the question. So let's answer some questions really quick and then we'll finish up with any last remarks.
Mm-hmm.
And what I'll do is,
I think we have another question.
Oh,
the
okay.
Muscular skeletal structure of one face affect perception. Yes, it does, but it's not as powerful of the skin itself. The skin itself convey a lot more message than the shape. The shape has some influence, but the skin is, I would say, like a notch above in terms of signal to the wrinkles, to the color, and the color heterogeneity.
Right, that's interesting. Okay, so are there any remaining sort of comments that you have before we close out on this?
One last thing. We tend to talk about cosmetic as a way of you know, fixing the sign and the cues we're using for health and age perception. But what we presented yesterday is people using products in the long term, you know, like serum, like we compare people using serum every day versus people not using serum every day in China. And people using serum every day were perceived 4 years younger than 4 years younger than people not using serum on a daily basis. And even products more like exfoliator on a weekly basis, you wouldn't think of that as you know, like a strong cosmetic, and still we could see 2 years differences in terms of perception between people using weekly exfoliator and people not using weekly exfoliator. So it's good to think that if you want to age gracefully as well, have a good routine and, you know, be proactive about it.
So all you skincare addicts out there that have your routines, it sounds like it pays off by four years. That's
beautiful.
It does.
It has to be think as a long-term investment.
A long-term investment. Okay, great. Well, that's it for this session. I'm going to ask you if I could see some photos from your presentation later, and I'll put them online so that, you know, I'll put them in a post so that you guys can see them, because when you showed the some of the examples,
mm-hmm,
of age perception in different countries, it was really interesting to look at that. And
yes, healthy and healthy older.
Exactly.
Yes.
Right. All right. Thank you so much. Take
care.
Thank
you guys. Bye.